Should James Gunn's The Suicide Squad be rated R? Back in November, it seemed like a no-brainer that it should. But now, in February, after Birds of Prey significantly underperformed at the box office, don't worry, we're going to talk about how people who've seen Birds of Prey have liked it, but not many people are seeing it. But now it seems that it obviously shouldn't be rated R. But in fact, it's still a tough decision, and I don't envy Warner Brothers when it comes to having to make it. So today, we're gonna explore the pros and cons, not only so you can better understand what Warner Brothers is going through, but also so we can discuss what we would do. And be sure to share your own thoughts on the matter down below. I know many of you are like, I already know the answer, Grace, but I think by the time we go through these pros and cons, you too won't be sure. All right, so pros. James Gunn already made a comic book movie about a ragtag group of misfits. A very well-known one, a very successful one. So an R rating would certainly help distinguish the Suicide Squad from Guardians of the Galaxy. And maybe even, and I'm sure Warner Brothers wants this, give it the edge, right? Because on that note, fans might feel that with an R rating, Gunn is unleashed. Allowed to be more loyal to his trauma roots and earlier films in general, which won him his core fan base. Speaking of loyal, they're very loyal. They almost single-handedly, well, I have to say, they really worked to get him out of his whole tweet drama, but I think so did the Guardians of the Galaxy cast. I mean, he cast a lot of people that another director wouldn't have cast, and they repaid him by really backing him up as well. And I've said that in light of that, and Kevin Feige's amazing loyalty to James Gunn, even after he went to DC to pull him back over to Disney, you have to factor that into your opinion of the man. Let's see if he can truly turn things around with this movie. I think it's a big test. Now, also, speaking of Gunn's R-rated films, right? No, any of them did well. Not a single one of them. Not even his recent ones, once he became a household name. But to be fair, Gunn only produced those films, and with the exception of Brightburn, co-wrote them. So you could argue, I think reasonably, that if Gunn himself were directing an R-rated film for a major franchise, for a major studio, with that kind of support and interest from fans, maybe it would do better. And beyond distinguishing the Suicide Squad from Gunn's Marvel work, it would also distinguish it from the MCU in general. This ain't your daddy's team-up movie. Plus, it's called the freaking Suicide Squad. They're criminals with bombs implanted in their heads so their Amanda Waller can make them do what she wants them to do. And they need a lot of convincing. Convincing that needs to be convincing because you have to believe that bomb in their head might go off. Which, in David Ayer's film, they didn't do very much. The bombs didn't really go off a lot. I mean, it was very hard to sell those aspects of the team in that PG-13 film, with people, with fans saying, these guys don't seem like criminals. They don't do a lot of criminal behavior, and not very many of them die. Again, on a team called the Suicide Squad. Let's remember that fans loved it when the R rating allowed their favorite characters to faithfully be portrayed on the big screen. We're talking Deadpool, Logan, Joker. Although to be fair, the Suicide Squad, trying to be fair here, you know, very balanced discussion, the Suicide Squad is not a particularly well-known comic. DC needed to add Harley Quinn to the team to get readers to be interested in it. When they first did it, everyone was shocked, particularly because she ran right into Deadshot's arms in a very odd way. But although everyone ate it up, and Harley Quinn joining the team has been a watershed moment for the title. She's actually, I think, become probably one of the most important members, along with Deadshot and Captain Boomerang and Amanda Waller, because she revitalized the comic, then the animated movie, and then Suicide Squad, the live-action film, being the one character to get a spinoff off of that movie. She tanked that, Margot Robbie tanked that opportunity, but still, it was amazing to behold. So Harley Quinn, I think, is actually better known than the Suicide Squad. And James Gunn's really running with that, with a lineup of characters that no one's really ever heard of. But the argument is that so he can kill so many of them off, which also I think is, you know, plays into wanting to have an R rating. Now, Guardians of the Galaxy, as I'm sure some of you have already commented down below, that was also not a particularly well-known comic. But the point I'm trying to make here is that unlike with Deadpool, Logan, and Wolverine and Joker, there isn't like something here that you need to be really faithful to. I don't know how much of a selling point that is in terms of faithfulness to the source material. All right, so anyway, I think overall, though, those are some pretty convincing pros. So let's take a look at the cons now to see what a tough spot Warner Brothers truly is in. All right, so cons. Unless you're trying to win an Oscar, at least get nominated, as these films were, Joker actually winning two, and a major one with Best Actor. And Deadpool, by the way, wasn't too shabby either, being nominated for two Golden Globes, Best Picture Comedy Musical and Best Actor Comedy Musical. That's impressive. I think with the R rating, it usually shows that you're trying to up your game. You're trying to do something different. Now, you have to ask yourself if that sounds like something James Gunn would do. I'm not so sure. But anyway, unless you're trying to get, and I don't think that he's the kind of filmmaker that the Academy would, that awards voters would embrace. They'd have to be thinking about that now. But I think beyond maybe getting some nominations, there's not too much gain as far as the studio is concerned with an R rating. I mean, Logan did well at the box office, sure, but not as well as Days of Future Past. Deadpool, Disney's likely going to make that character PG-13 going forward, so he can not only be included in the MCU, but also the theme parks, which I think Ryan Reynolds would love. Ryan Reynolds is a very savvy businessman, and I think he can surely see the benefit to Deadpool being able to be included more so in the vast Disney empire. Would you like a Disney magic band with Deadpool on it? They can't really do that if he's rated R, but if he's PG-13, I think they could sell a lot of those, right? I mean, wouldn't you maybe like to buy one? Wouldn't you like to have a Deadpool character meet and greet at the parks? Can't really do that for an R-rated character. Now, Free Guy, interestingly enough, isn't rated yet, but odds are it will be PG-13, with many speculating, I think accurately, that this Fox, now Disney Fox movie, is going to be a test. Disney's going to push for that PG-13 rating for Free Guy, because they want to see if Deadpool would succeed as a PG-13 film, because of course the two are very similar, down to their star. Now look, I too would miss the stabby action of both Deadpool and Wolverine, but considering how interconnected the MCU is and how effective that is, I think we might just have to take the loss there. And that doesn't mean that Deadpool and Wolverine can't still deliver amazing action sequences with smart, savvy directors, writers, and of course, Kevin Feige looking after them. I think it's so hard, but I think that both Deadpool and Wolverine have other wonderful elements that don't need to be rated R. It's right on the edge with them. I do see that. You really have to balance the pros and cons. Now, as for Joker, that took a very serious Scorsese, literally Scorsese tone, with an R rating not just for violence, but artful, powerful, meaningful violence. You can't cut away at that fatal moment at the Murray Franklin show, or throughout the film. You know, the whole point is to see it unfold before you, but you'd have to cut away if it was PG-13. But then also on top of the violence, there's a whole slew of adult themes in that movie. But again, look at the set picks for James Gunn's The Suicide Squad. Gunn ain't channeling Scorsese. I also think that Gunn has historically had a problem with issues of taste and appropriateness, and I'd have some concern that he would go too far with an R rating. That maybe it's the PG-13 rating that keeps him in line and keeps him appealing to mainstream audiences. And on that note, right about now, some of you might be like, well, Grace, I think this all sounds great, just the way it is. And while you might enjoy an R-rated The Suicide Squad movie very much, how many people will overall? That's the question, of course, Warner Brothers has to ask themselves. Because again, as I said, a lot of the people who went to see Birds of Prey really enjoyed it. But the problem is that not a lot of people are going to see the movie, period. David Ayer's Suicide Squad made a lot of money because teenagers went to see it a lot of times. The loss of those teenagers is very much hurting Birds of Prey and could hurt the Suicide Squad as well. So again, even in the wake of Birds of Prey's box office blunder, it still, I think, is a really tough decision. And at the end of the day, Warner Brothers needs to look at what Gunn's filming and decide if it really makes good use of the R rating. Does it really need to be rated R? And is it rated R in a way that would appeal to mainstream audiences, not just Gunn's loyal core fan base, which is very much the foundation of his success, but it's not going to be enough to get him across the finish line. You know, I think you'd have a similarly a small audience as you did for Birds of Prey. They'd be also very happy, but again, you'd have a small, much smaller box office. Because I think we all agreed that Birds of Prey, at the end of the day, actually didn't even need to be rated R with the way that it turned out. So see how it's coming together. That's what the Warner Brothers executives are getting paid the big bucks for. Decide where the movie falls and if cuts need to be made. I would also consider releasing a PG-13 cut of the movie, and then for HBO Max, or when it came out for streaming overall, like for Blu-ray, I might have an R-rated cut. And that's how maybe I would get around this. I'd be like, go see it in theaters, PG-13. But don't worry, you're going to see it in all its full bloody glory in like 3 months. That's probably what I would consider doing at this point, considering what happened to Birds of Prey. And I think, would you be happy with that compromise if you were a fan? Or if you are a fan, obviously. All right, so share your thoughts down below. Subscribe today. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.